Everyone, it's me, Betty, and it is a beautiful afternoon here in New Zealand, and I'm excited to tell you that I finished my Pilates certification. So, in honor of that, I will be working through the classical Pilates exercises over my next few videos. There's 34 in all, so today we'll do the first 11. So go ahead, grab your mat, let's get started. The first exercise we'll do is called the 100. I did this in another one of my videos, and it's a great one that actually involves your arms and your abs and your core and your legs and pretty much your whole body, which is a great kind of get that fire going in your body. So go ahead and lie down on your mat. We'll start in a neutral spine. So let's just do a little bit of an ab prep. So you want to feel like your belly button is dropping down to your spine. You have a little space behind your back. And then from here, we're going to tip our pelvis so that we're sealing any space between your lower back and your mat. And then relax back to neutral spine. Good, let's do that again. So inhale. Exhale, slightly tip your pelvis up. Inhale here. And exhale back to neutral spine. Good, so we'll do that one more time. Inhale here. Exhale as you tip your pelvis, warming up those abdominals. Inhale. And exhale back to neutral spine. Okay, so hug both knees into the chest. And we'll start right away with 100. So curl your upper body up, shoot your legs out and your arms out. So roll your shoulder blades down. You can have your legs up here or you can lower them to about a 45 degree angle. So start pumping your arms vigorously and let's go. And in, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale. Exhale, inhale, exhale, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Great. Next, we're going to do the roll-up. You can either do it with bent knees or with stretched knees. So you start with your arms overhead, reach your fingertips up to the ceiling, and slowly curling into a C shape, come all the way up. This is one option. You can come up with bent knees and then slowly roll down. Feel like somebody's pulling you backwards and then lower all the way back down, arms just over your head. So we'll do that 5 times. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale, and exhale, inhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, you're doing great. Last time, inhale. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Next, we'll do the roll over. So from here, you can flex your feet, and you're going to roll up with your feet together, then spread your feet apart, and slowly roll down. We'll do it this way. Flex your feet. Inhale. Spread your feet. Slowly roll down. And feet together. Inhale. Spread your feet apart. Exhale with control. Inhale. Exhale.
And slowly down.
Okay, so now we're going to reverse that. So we'll flex our feet, go over with your legs apart, squeeze them together, and then slowly roll down. And finish with your legs apart. Inhale.
Slowly exhale. Inhale. Doing great.
Inhale, feet together, roll down, and inhale,
and exhale down.
Good. So go ahead and leave your right leg up. Your left leg can slowly drop down to the floor, and we're going to do leg circles. So slightly rotate your leg, cross it over to the midline, down and around, up,
cross, down and around, and up.
Cross, down around and up. Cross, down around and up. Pause. We'll do one more here and then we'll reverse. Open, around and up. Open,
this is clockwise.
Open, down and up. Open,
down and up. Open, down and up.
Good. Hug your knee into your chest and we'll switch legs.
Left leg goes up to the ceiling.
Slight external rotation. Cross, down and around, and up. Cross, down and around, and up. So you can do it just about shoulder width apart. Doesn't have to be huge circles. As you gain more strength and control, your circle can get bigger and bigger. Let's do one more. Down and around, and up. Good. Now we'll go counterclockwise. Open,
down and around, and up.
Good. Down and up.
Down and up. Down and around and up.
Let's do one more. Down and around and up. Good. Hug that knee into your chest.
Good. And then we'll slowly come up.
Next is rolling like a ball. So you want to hug your knees, really your shins, sitting up nice and tall. Go up on your tippy toes here. You want to hollow out your tummy, so belly button to spine. Feel like somebody's pulling you back until you roll back and come up. We'll do that 5 times. Try and find your balance when you get to the top. Rolling back and come up. Back and come up. Good. Back and come up. Back
and come up. Come up. Back. Come up.
Good. Feet on the ground. Slowly roll down. Hug your right knee into your chest. Reach your left leg long for single leg stretch. So you want to lift your upper body up. And we'll switch. Grab your opposite knee. Switch. 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 Nice and controlled. Switch.
Inhaling and exhaling.
Switch. 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 Good. Hug both knees into your chest. Right away into double leg stretch. Arms and leg goes out and come around. Keeping that nice neutral spine. Out and around. Out and around. Out and around. Belly button in. Out and around, out and around. Good. Go ahead and rock on up. Next, we'll do spine stretch forward. So you want your feet about hip width apart, feet flexed back towards you, sitting up nice and tall. We simply curl our neck down into a C shape, reaching forward, reach, 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 and coming up. So this one actually took me a long time to figure out exactly what you're supposed to do here, because it doesn't feel like much, and having been a dancer my whole life, I just wanted to flop forward and stretch. We're actually stretching the vertebra. So when you start really tall, you want to curl your head forward, feel like somebody's pulling you backwards almost, and you're trying to reach forward. So you're stretching the vertebra, And then you restack your spine and sit up straight. So hopefully that helps you. We'll go forward. Make sure you reach your fingertips. And sitting up tall. Reach forward. And sitting up tall. I actually feel this in my lower back. Reaching forward. We'll do two more. And sit up. Good. Reaching forward. And sit up. Good. Okay, so the next one we'll do is rocking with open legs. It's a little bit tricky. So just try your best. So we'll sit nice and tall. You're going to lift your leg. Then try and find your other one. Squeeze your belly button into your spine. And we're going to rock back, very similar to rolling like a ball. So if this is too difficult for you, you can just do rolling like a ball. So sit up nice and tall. We rock back. And then come up. Sit nice and tall. Rock back. And sit up tall. Rock back. Sit up nice and tall. Rock back. Sit up nice and tall. Belly button to spine as you roll back. And sit up nice and tall. Great job. Next, we will transition to corkscrew. So that starts laying on your back. Goodness, I made my mat all Crooks McGee over here. Sorry about that. Okay, so roll down. Corkscrew is similar to single leg stretch, or sorry, single leg circles. So hug your knees into your chest. Doesn't that feel good? Legs go up to the ceiling, slight external rotation, and you're just going to make your legs like a corkscrew. So we rock over to one side, down, around, and up. Over to one side, down, around, and up. Over to one side, down, around, and up. Feeling both pelvis bones on the floor, sit bones on the floor, down, around, and up. Over to one side. Sorry, it's hard to talk and do this at the same time. Good, now we'll go the other way. Over to the right. Down, around, and up. Over to the left. Down, around, and up. Squeezing those legs together. Zip them up. Over to the side. Down, around, and up. You're doing awesome. Down, around, and up. Over to the side. Down, around, and up. Good. Hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a nice little cuddle here. Good. Feet on the ground. Slowly roll up. Next is the saw. So, same idea, very similar to spine stretch forward. So you have your feet flexed about hip width apart. Your arms will go to the side. Sitting up nice and tall, having that sense of neutral spine here, belly button to spine, with a little space. You're going to twist to one side and saw your baby toe off. Good. And then reverse and come back up. Twist, saw your baby toe, and come back up. So sitting up nice and tall, twist, saw your baby toe off, and come back up. Twist, saw your baby toe off, and come back up. We've done two on each side. Three more to go. Twist, saw, and come up. Twist. Saw and come up, twist, saw and come up. Make sure you're breathing here. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, last time, exhale, inhale, and exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, and exhale. Great job. Next we have, we'll do one more. It's called swan dive. So go ahead and flip over onto your belly. Put your hands right under your shoulders. So first we're just going to push up and stretch our back and our abs that we just worked out so hard. Inhale and exhale down. Inhale here,
chin up, like a little cobra, and exhale down.
Good. Next, we're going to go into swan dive prep.
So we'll inhale here, then we'll rock forward, then back up and catch ourselves. Rock and catch ourselves here. Inhale, exhale, rock forward, catch yourself here. Inhale, exhale, rock forward, and catch yourself here. Inhale, rock forward, and catch yourself here.
So now if you'd like to try the full version of swan, we'll inhale, we'll shoot our arms forward, and then you rock back and forth just a few times, and then arms and legs go down. Relax your back, catch your breath. We'll do it one more time, so push up, inhale here, pinching your shoulder blades together so you're nice and open through your collarbone. Exhale, arms go forward, rock back and forth.
And then slowly relax everything down onto the mat
and push back into a nice child's pose. Thanks everyone for joining me. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and share these exercises with your friends.
Take a couple more breaths.
Pilates is so good for posture and breathing and control and coordination amongst other things. Just take a couple moments to be grateful that you had this opportunity to work your body, your mind, your heart, and your spirit.